glad you're with us. Saturday baseball on the show. It's the Houston Astros and the Boston Red Sox. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Just about to get started, and on the hill in this one, Tanner Houck.
Yeah, as Wes tells you, he's been pretty effective this year on the mound. The opposing hitters having a hard time getting on base and then being able to really distract him and do damage in terms of getting around the base path. So, taking the mound, this is a guy you want out there if you're his teammate, and I expect him to be good in this one. Here's Alex Bregman.
Back in inside Fenway Park and getting the start, Spencer Arrighetti. Chris, he's got the ability to take control of a game when he's out there.
Both incredible mound presence, and he's going to attack hitters. Look at that strikeout per nine ratio over 10 coming into this start. So he's a pitcher that wants the ball. He's aggressive. He knows that he can get the swing and miss, especially when he needs it most. We'll see how effective he is in this one.
Next offering in there for a strike. And the count 1-2. Got him looking. That's a strikeout. Still stepping in for Boston, Willier Abreu. That's a strike. Abreu measures 5 feet 10 inches, 215 pounds, and he was born in Venezuela. Settles under it, and there's two away. Time now to check out the lineup for the Boston Red Sox. And Chris, this group has been struggling to put up runs lately.
Well, they haven't been on base a ton, and even when they are, they haven't been hitting very well with runners on base. So they need a guy or two to really step up, have some quality at bats, hit according to the situation, and sort of break out of this. I think if they do, the rest of this lineup will follow.
Bregman is under it. Nothing doing here this half. On to the second from Fenway Park. It's the Astros 6 and the Red Sox nothing. And we're back. Now it's Alex Bregman. The pitch. And that one hammered out towards left field. That one back there, and it is gone way over the monster. A gigantic blast. His second home run of the game. It's 7-0. That was blasted.
Absolutely. No doubt off the bat. The pitcher knew as soon as that ball left his fingertips, it was trouble. Right on a platter, right down the heart of the plate. I'm sorry, but big league hitters don't miss that pitch.
Lace to right, center base hit.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front, ripped into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a pure stroke.
Diaz batting for the second time, and that's strike one. And it's fouled away. Righty deals. Got him swinging.
Just overmatched on that fastball right there. And it wasn't like he was set up for it by something off speed earlier in the at bat. Just came right after him with 3 straight, and he had no answer for it.
On a line, base hit. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds it second with one gone.
Wastes no time there. Didn't try to do too much with it. Just a really controlled, simple swing. We don't see a whole lot of that these days with hitters trying to launch and hit home runs.
That one ripped right center field. And it hops over the wall for an automatic double. And a run comes in to score. Two on with one out. And stepping in for the Astros, Zach Vincenzo. Fought off foul. Two on, one out. Over to Smith. Out number two, and another run comes in. Brad Keller gets the ball now.
And he's had a struggle so far this year. As you can see, the inflated ERA. Looking to bring that down a little bit right here.
Here's the center fielder, Jake Myers. He drove in two with a double his first time up. The other way. Nabs it, and that'll do it. So they get 3 runs on 4 hits. One was the solo homer. They go to the bottom of inning number 2. It's the Astros 9 and the Red Sox nothing. Back here at Fenway, bottom of the inning. Here's the third baseman, Rafael Devers. swing and a pop-up foul and a play off to the right side. That'll find a stands. And he deals. And a big swing and a miss.
Well, every pitcher wants run support, and having a lead is nice, but it can be challenging for some pitchers. I think keeping the mindset to attack instead of trying to be too fine and have too much finesse, go after hitters and get quick outs.
Kicks and deals. And Devers hits that one. One away. And now, Connor Wong. Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. Pulls it in for the out. Two outs, bases empty. Dominic Smith getting ready to hit. Swings through that one.
In the on-deck circle, you really want to use that opportunity to see some pitches and time up the fastball. Last thing you want to do is miss a good hittable fastball early in the count.
Two outs, bases empty. Swing and a miss. Close one, doesn't get the call. It's 2-2. To center. That's this one sized up. He makes the grab, and that'll do it. And we're back here at Fenway Park. New inning getting started. Liner up the middle to base hit. So now back to the top of the order.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Jose Altuve up to hit here. Lined into left center, and that should be extra bases. Throw comes in. Runner stops. Second and third. Nobody out. And that's a double. And now it's Alex Bregman. And that one is lifted in the air. Touches down. That's a hit. Oh, he throws it away. And they put the tag on him for the out. Space is empty. Next is the designated hitter, 1-2. And it gets by him. Around first, heading for two. They're still chasing it as he rounds second.
Absolutely hammered that baseball. Very loud coming off the bat. 107 was the exit velocity, and at that speed, it's going to be a great result more often than not.
Now, Jeremy Pena. That's a base hit as a run scores.
He was all over that one. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great. Next to hit. Line drive, base hit right field. Around second is Pena. And the throw's offline, safe at third. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always pay. Ball, this one high and deep, way back there. Goodbye, home run! A massive home run. It's their second home run of the inning. It's 16-0. That's their fifth homer of the game.
Man, they're all getting into the action. It's starting to feel like a home run derby up here. Love to see a hitter aggressive on the first pitch of an at-bat. You watch him.
Brennan Bernardino will take over here. This southpaw's been really good against left-handed hitters. And now the right fielder, Mauricio Dubon. Ripped to short. Zips it to first. And that is that. But two-round trippers in this inning, the long ball was working. We head now to the home half of inning number three. Major League Baseball is on the show. Back here in Boston, set for the bottom of the third. Here now the Red Sox DH, number 97. Swing and a foul straight back.
You know, these Red Sox, as you probably noticed, haven't been shy at the plate at all. In fact, they've probably been too aggressive at times. I'm specifically talking about the first pitch. These guys are swinging more than 80% of the time, which is fine if you're scoring runs, but that hasn't been the case today.
Popped up on the left side of the infield. Bregman is under it, and there's one down. At the plate, Sidane Rafaela. Top of the zone for a called strike. Swing and a fly ball in the air out towards right center field. Nice grab on the run. And a couple of quick outs. And first offering is fouled off. Two down, nobody on. Foul ball. The Red Sox down to their final strike. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. He pulls it down, ball game. And the Astros take this one in a blowout.
After four wins in a row, you start to think a little bit that you're on a roll. And that's the momentum that just takes on a life of its own. Players start hitting up and down the lineup. You never know who's going to come up with the big hit, who's going to come out of the bullpen and get the big outs. But it's a good feeling if you want to extend it.
Well, this one ends in a blowout. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Chompy. We'll see you soon.